As simple as that sounds, it's obviously difficult to practice. We get angry with one another, and so we split off and won't talk. We refuse to reconcile. We say things on purpose that will hurt people's feelings because somehow we think it'll make us feel better when we're angry. We neglect our brothers and sisters who have less than we do, and we watch them suffer, and yet instead of stepping out of love and giving out of our abundance, we oftentimes hold back for a rainy day. We don't stop and think, what is the most loving thing I can do for my neighbor? Many times we stop and think, what is the most convenient thing I can do? We live in a world full of pain and suffering. And many times when we're at our best, we hear stories of those who reach out and go way beyond. That's the truth of love. But when we're at our worst, we draw back and we mumble and we grumble and we read the newspaper and we say, what a lousy world. And yet we don't do anything about it. We don't go out and live in a way that will change it. We don't go out and make a difference. The gospel message is that God loved the world so much that he sent his son to us. Not only to die for our sins, but to show us the truth of how much God loved us. And then he challenged us to live in that way. To live in a way that decides things based on what is the most loving thing I can do. That's the truth of the gospel message, that we live lives based on the love of God in us. It's not easy. It's often hard. It can take you in many different places. This week alone, I started off sad. Pearl Wright passed away. Many of you know that. You don't know we were here on Sunday, you know that we were praying for her because she's getting ready to go in a hospice. She passed away on Monday. On Tuesday, my grandchild was born. That was exciting and happy time. Thursday, I had a wedding rehearsal. On Thursday night, Ralph called me with some of the most tragic news I'd ever heard, where his nephew had passed away at 27 years old on his honeymoon out of the country. It's just a devastating time. On Friday was the wedding. On Saturday was Pearl's funeral. And today we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. There's so many places that the love of God pulls us because of the way life spins itself. God calls us to be in each and every one of those situations with all of his love. Not all of our love, but with all of his love. He challenges us to be in those relationships in a way that may be sacrificial because we're giving everything we have at that moment, in that situation, to be with those who are either celebrating or grieving. For those who are excited about life, for those who are afraid. But nothing will happen until the church moves out from this building, from any building that they're in, into life, into the world, in a way represented by the truth of God. It's called Christ the King Sunday because Christ did claim to be king. Not an earthly king, but a king in heaven. The king of the world, if you will, in the sense that it's the king of all that we know. And those who hear his voice, the very last part of the text says this, which I had it memorized, but my mind's not so working real well. The very last part of the text says in John 18:37, says this, he can testify the truth, and everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice. The kingdom of God is present when those who hear him, listen to him, and obey him. That's what it means to be a part of the kingdom of God. When we come and we join the church, we claim that we will let Christ be our Lord, our King. And we what he calls us to do. He also says his burden is light and easy. His yoke is easy. It's all about living out that relationship. The relationship of reconciliation that he calls us to. Today we celebrate a baptism. That baptism is ushering another member into the body of Christ, into the kingdom of God. That baptism recognizes Luke as a member of this kingdom. One of us together, living out a life of love. And the congregation promises to support the family, Eric and Danielle, but to support them in raising their child in the kingdom of God. It connects us. It binds us together as we come together in that one body, that one kingdom under God, living that life out that supports one another in either the celebrations or the grief or just a daily grind of life, but that gives to one another based on the truth that God has given us, the truth that He is life, and that He wants to share that with us. Today we celebrate Christ the King Sunday. He's our Lord, He's our Savior, but He came to testify to the truth of God's love that we might be empowered to share that love with the world, to heal the world, to transform the world of the brokenness of the hate. That's my challenge for us this day. As we continue in our path, as we celebrate Thanksgiving, as we celebrate Christmas coming up, that we remember why we do these things. Because Christ is King, and He leads us in love.